Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Well, you have seen like the 2 minutes video every time, so I also have a video to show. That's not 2 minutes though, 2 hours and 2 minutes. There's a lot of things that I want to show or to share. Okay, when I first been invited by Chris, thank you very much, Chris, for having the fee, calling me here, inviting me here. Okay, I am like, you are like blocking the other people's view. when I was first invited, I was like a bit lost, I would say. Tak tahu apa benda sebenarnya yang Chris buat ni. Dia duk bam 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 dekat Twitter, you know. Oh, this spark here, spark there. And then I said, okay, tell me, when he asked me whether I want to join his activity, and I just say yes, because I believe in him. Through Twitter, can you imagine, through the virtual world, daripada dunia maya ni pun, I boleh mendapat seorang kawan dan I percaya pada kawan, mana tahu dia ni perokok ke kan? I tak tahu kan, perokok ke, penipu ke, conman ke. But somehow or other, ada gerak hati, okay, that says like, go for it. When dia cakap pasal pelajar-pelajar, bila masuk bab pelajar saja, saya memang pada waktu itu terus cakap, yes, I will do it. I don't know what I am into, I just say, yes, I will do it. For the record, actually, this is not the first time I buat talks in front of the college or university student. I've been around, been going around to, I went to Islam Laya. Ada berapa Islam Laya tak kat sini? Satu je. Dua je. Okay, I pergi ke UITM. I pergi ke... Okay, and when I was invited here, I was like not really sure how should I dress up. I said, I don't know what to expect. I don't know what kind of crowd I am like standing in front. Diorang ni relax ke? Tense ke, tegang ke, kejung ke, ngada-ngada ke, getik ke, tak tahu. Yeah, so I don't know what to wear, really. And I have changed like a lot of baju just now. Okay, this is it. No. This is too much. And then when I pakai ni, oh, this is like under. Nampak murah pula aku kat sini kan. And I cakap, never mind. And then, this is the best baju I could find. I rasa macam I dah overdress dah dekat sini. But never mind, there's a privilege of being somebody, a personality or celebrity, that if you are overdressed, you still will be accepted. So it's okay, so I don't care. And then, tak ambil kat baju lagi, ambil kat rambut pula. I blew rambut macam ni, I blew rambut tegak, I tengok, I blew rambut kat sini, masuk macam ni, akhirnya, tak kisahlah, rambut macam mana pun, akhirnya datang, I know people who wants to come here, not only to listen to me, they want to see how I look personally, kan, in front of their naked eyes. Dia nak tengok sini, asli ni betul-betul ke tua, kan, macam yang aku tengok kat TV, dia ni betul-betul ke kecil orang, dia comel dan kurus, handsome, lagi lawan kan, gitu kan. So, there's a lot of expectations now, and I'm to come here, but just to come here, there's a lot of expectation. And to start with, I would like to share with you how I first started to be different. Okay, boleh tak? Can you bear with me or not?
Yes.
Because I rasa diri saya ni sangat berbeza daripada orang. How should I address myself to you? Because Pak Neil, yes. Kalau abang tak boleh, because I think my anak also besar you all. Ada 22 tahun kat sini. Anak 22 tahun, perempuan belajar dekat Australia sekarang, belum berpunya. I rasa ada boyfriend dia datang, siapa nama bapak you? Azdil ya? Ha, bapak Azdil. So, boyfriend dia lari yang ingatkan. That's why, mak nak kata, ayo, your name kan, I don't know whether it's a luck or jinx tau. Every time I'm in a relationship aja, my boyfriend semua lari. Mesti bapak you banyak tanya kan? Mesti kena interview. No lah, I'm a happy-go-lucky person. Okay, masa I was born in 1962. Siapa dah lahir masa tu? Dinosaur eh? Dinosaur. The last species. Okay, I was born in 1962. Masa itu kan, mana ada internet ke? There's no internet. Ada TV pun 1967 pun ada TV. Huh. 1962 kita dengar suara makcik-makcik nyanyi kat radio kan? Nani, nani, nani. Oh, seronoknya, masa tu seronoknya, makcik nyanyi sedapnya kan. So, as time goes by, I was saya kalau ikutkan eh, all the time I'm in Kuala Lumpur. I don't know about some of you dekat daripada Kelantan, some of you maybe from Kedah, from Johor, but I am all the time in Kuala Lumpur. I witness a lot of development in Kuala Lumpur. So daripada 1962, so I brought up, I pergi sekolah, sekolah pun sekolah rendah jenis kebangsaan lagi zaman tu. Sekolah rendah jenis kebangsaan, dia ada jenis binatang eh. Jenis haiwan lain-lain lah. So dia ni jenis kebangsaan ni jenis orang. So I am the last batch also yang masa itu belajar mengikut curriculum penjajah. British punya curriculum. So kita orang look like, we look up to J.W. Birch kan? We look up to Clifford. We look up to Anderson. We look down on Mat Kilau. We look down, really, masa itu. We look down on Maharaja Lela, semua tahu, Datuk Maharaja Lela. Because itulah dia punya orientation. I dilahirkan begitu. So, Mat Kilau yang Maharaja Lela ni kita nampak macam pembunuh, pemberontak, kan? But anyway, I adalah juga, nak share lagi ni, I juga adalah orang yang sangat petik, kecil aja. Ha, dah form 1 pun I macam dah jah 5. So kecil, and then kena bully aja, lembik, lemah lembut, dan comel. So, experience dia ialah I tak banyak dapat peluang untuk bersama geng-geng lelaki yang lain. Mereka tak nak campur dengan I. Perempuan pun tak nak campur dengan I. So I nak campur dengan siapa ni? So I campur dengan cikgu lah. So I bawa buku cikgu. Cikgu punya buku-buku student tu I tukang bawa. Kadang-kadang buku tu lagi tinggi pada I. Bawa dalam tu kan. So I grew up in that kind of environment tau. I balik, aku tunggu kau kat luar. Kat teman, aku nak kena pukul lagi ke? Ini duduk KL ni. Siapa aku balik? Aku tak tahu dosa aku apa pun. Tiba-tiba pandang je, kepada aku apa? Balik aku tunggu kau kat luar. So macam tu lah. Memang hidup I penuh ketakutan. And I am in the situation where I hardly speak my mind. I am like sangat tertutup, sangat fragile. And then I go into university. The first time ever when I stepped into University of Malaya, I orang KL. Sepatutnya I tak dapat duduk dekat college. Yang patut duduk dekat college ialah orang-orang seperti daripada Kelantan, Johor and what not kan, yang semua daripada Kuala Lumpur, luar daripada Kuala Lumpur. Tetapi I'm taking that one big chance to get out from my old surroundings. I keluar, I cakap dengan diri I told myself, I said, no, every time kalau I duduk bawah ketiak mak, I will never see the world. So, pergi Universiti Melayu lagi macam see the world already at that time. Padahal naik bas 20 sen je. Okay. So, I duduk keramat. Universiti dekat lepas pantai. It's like so near. It's only 20 cents at that time. 1982?
Dia ada lelaki belum?
Masa tu, so I kata, no matter what, I just want to get out from the house. I want to be with the rest of my friend. I want to be, I want to stay in hostel. But how can I do that? Because I orang KL, I will never get to stay in the hostel. Because priority akan dibagi pada orang luar ber-KL. So, what I did, I masuk selagi ada benda yang dekat masa minggu orientasi. I masuk selagi ada benda. Menyanyi, boleh menyanyi juga. Okay, kita ada pertandingan debat. I boleh debat. Gol hati. Kita nak cari pemain hoki. I main hoki. Walaupun tak kerti apa. Kan? I ambil bahagian selagi ada. I make myself felt. My presence felt. In university, I don't care. See, I must get a space in hostel. This is the only time I could like get out from my old surrounding. So, true enough, I am the first name to be announced. Okay, Azel, congratulations, you get a place in asrama pertama. You seem like I get wow, oh, bye bye ma, bye bye. Actually, it's bye bye me. It's actually bye bye me. Okay, and I begin to be on my own. I begin to make my own decision. I begin to do things that I like. I begin to attend class at my time. I begin to go to college or go to the lecture at the right time. Kan? Semua I decide lah. Daripada situ, then only I realize that actually there's ada cerita juga. I pergi masuk universiti Melayu is to track my idol. My idol, Datuk Sudirman Haji Arshad. Wah, seronoknya dia dekat Universiti Melaya. Kan? I kata I nak pergi track dia punya journey. Dia pergi, ini dia dia punya apa fakulti dia dekat. Because I ada idol tau. I ada idol, so I track. Oh, dia menyanyi dekat Universiti Melaya. I nyanyi walaupun orang tak suruh. Walaupun tiap kali nyanyi hujan lebat turun. I don't care. And then lepas itu, I tahu dia masuk debat. I masuk debat. I masuk selagi ada benda. And I make myself like very, very visible tau dekat Universiti Melayu. So, over there, I masuk persatuan menari. Belajar. Okay je lah. Tak adalah I bodoh. Sangat kan? Hai, hello, masa Universiti Melayu. You all tahu lah kan, orang Universiti Melayu semua. Kan? Tapi, pada waktu yang sama, I tak tinggalkan the activities. Kan? And at the same time, that's where I build how I start to know, to communicate. I begin to learn how to make friends. I begin to learn how to do my PR work and then do my networking dekat Universiti Melayu. Padahal masa tu, it's not... They don't call it networking. Masa tu dia panggil bodek, kan? Zaman sekarang panggil, oh, very good, networking. Dulu-dulu sebenarnya kipas, kan? Cantik kakak punya baju hari ni. Eh, adik, minum dengan kakak, dik. Gitu, kan? Itu pekerja-pekerja dekat universiti. Senang nak dapat beasiswa, kita masuk dalam, orang ni beratur, kan? Kita masuk dalam sebab adik, angkat, gitu, kan? So, okay. Itu benda yang I belajar dekat universiti. So, sekarang I nak share dengan you. As I said, what actually the little thing that you do can create a difference in your life. Satu benda yang kecil sedikit aja sebenarnya akan menyebabkan satu perubahan yang sangat besar dalam diri anak-anak Pak Lin yang dekat bawah dekat sekarang ni yang ada dekat dalam dewan ni. Okay, sebenarnya Pak Lin ni bukanlah hidup dalam keluarga tentera tak. Bapa saya cuma seorang pekerja syarikat bas. Okay, tetapi kenapa Pak Neil, tak tahulah. I am like very punctual. I will be there on time, if not earlier. Itu adalah benda yang Pak Neil belajar. So sekarang ini, kalau you all nak mula melangkah ke dunia pekerjaan, okay, tak kira lah you all nak kerja apa ke, kan? The moment that you want to join the companies, or maybe some of you start your own business or whatever, kan? Alright, one thing yang selalu Pak Nek cakap ni nak membebe sikit ni pasal pengurusan masa, time management. Dulu tak ada orang panggil tu time management tau tak? Sekarang ni kemain ni bunyi ni macam time management, Kan? Kedua, buat suara cerita time management. Nampak? Korporat sikit. Sebenarnya dulu adalah sama ada kau lambat atau, ataupun kau cepat. Okay? Sama ada kau datang pada waktu yang tepat ataupun tidak. So sekarang ini, kalau you nak pergi untuk pergi temuduga, for example, kalau nak pergi temuduga umpamanya, okay, janganlah kata anak-anak semua sekarang ni datang dapat surat gembira ni, awak dipanggil untuk temuduga, baru temuduga ya, maknanya ada 200 lagi calon yang akan berentap dengan awak untuk berlakukan satu kerja tu je, satu kerja kosong, satu je tempat dia. Nak dipanggil sampai 200 orang datang untuk temuduga. What can you do to make yourself like visible, nampak your presence of felt daripada 200 itu? Doesn't take much. Just be there on time. Itu saja. Ada keluar duit tak? No. Tak ada kan? Tak ada keluar duit apa pun sebenarnya. Just go there on time or earlier. Okay, for example, kalau dia kata pukul 9 datang, kata your interview start at 9, you come at 8:30. Biarlah kalau nak kata you duduk dekat luar, pintu tak buka lagi pun tak apa. Kan? Dan yang pentingnya diorang nampak you. Budak ni awal je datang. Okay, so kalau benda ni you cultivate daripada mula awak bekerja lagi, dia dah tunjuk dah, orang dah nampak kan, budak ni bagus lah. And selalunya orang pertama datang juga akan ingat, dia akan ingat nama dia. Nama you apa tadi? You bukan orang pertama kan datang kan? That's why tak ingat. Okay, nampak tak? Selalu orang pertama datang dia akan ingat. Doesn't take much kan? You datang awal saja. Bila you datang awal, then people will remember your face and you will be given, of course lah, kalau you datang, you akan orang pertama yang masuk. Satu lagi, you akan mempunyai masa yang relax. You can calm yourself. Okay, you calm yourself, lepas tu duduk, get used to the environment. Sometimes kalau kita masuk tempat yang selalu kita datang, kita rasa macam lain macam kan, sebab benda tu bukan, we are not used to the surrounding kan, bila datang macam pelik.